2. Around the Weird. Here's your host, the museum curator of the strange and unusual, Mr. Nothing.
Thank you, Mysterious Voice, and welcome back to Around the Weird, a BookTube channel, where I talk about all the unusual and out-of-the-ordinary literature that I have found in my travels. Today, it is Short Story Tuesday, and I wanted to talk about a short story that I read that is actually a children's story, or a story written for children. It is about a magical train. I am referring to The Polar Express by Chris Van Allsburg. For those who don't know, Chris Van Allsburg is a well-known children's author. He has written Jumanji as well as Zathura and numerous other stories and won many awards for those stories. He published The Polar Express in 1985 and it was later adapted into a movie, which some people have said it suffers from the uncanny valley and a whole bunch of issues with the CGI, which wasn't quite there. Although I disagree, I think the CGI works more often than not, and The Polar Express is one of my favorite Christmas movies. So I actually heard that it was a movie before I knew that it was a book. So I think I have a love of the movie that maybe I don't share as much for the book, but I do like the book and some of the ideas that it focuses on. So this story was, again, published in 1985, and it's another children's story. I have a tendency to talk about those from time to time, as those count as short stories. And it's always fun to, you know, see what children's literature does. Because I look at young adult fiction, but I don't look at enough stories aimed for, you know, young children around 6, 7, 8, 9 years old. Because we should always, you know, look at what is being offered to those children. Because although, like, young kids can be stupid at times, that doesn't necessarily mean we should slack off when we're presenting them with stuff to read. So stuff to consider there. So without further ado, let's talk about The Polar Express. I will do a summary, a little bit of an analysis, and we will move on from there. So The Polar Express focuses on an unnamed young boy as he waits for Santa at night. He was told by a friend that Santa isn't real, and so he is at that point where he's trying to figure out if that's true or if he's been lied to by somebody. And so he's just sitting in bed waiting to hear Santa's sleigh bells when suddenly a train shows up in his house. The conductor calls him over and says, "Hey, this is the train to the North Pole." And the young boy gets on because he can't possibly be lying. It's not every day a train shows up right in front of your house. So the train passes through mountains, a series of forests, and past the icy landscape of the Arctic. And from there, they arrive at the North Pole, where there are a bunch of elves walking through the street, and there is a big celebration. Santa shows up and begins walking over towards the kids who showed up on the Polar Express as he is about to give the first gift of Christmas. He chooses the young boy, and the young boy selects the sleigh bell for some unknown reason, although we later learn it's because, you know, hearing is believing for this child. He celebrates that, and then he gets back to the train and he discovers there was a hole in his bathrobe when he put the sleigh bell in it, and so he actually lost the sleigh bell, and the train begins heading back home. The next morning, the young boy and his sister open presents for Christmas, and he discovers that Santa found the bell and put it in with his Christmas gifts. But for some reason, his parents can't hear the bell, but he and his sister can. The narrator then goes on to say that over the years, his sister eventually lost the ability to hear the bell, but he has always heard it because, as the story ends, he notes that the bell will always ring for those who still believe in the magic of Santa. In terms of analysis, there is a bit to talk about with this story. The first thing worth noting and what this entire story is really about is that of belief in Santa Claus. It seems like at the beginning of the story, the boy has his doubts because someone has told him that Santa isn't real. It's interesting to see how the boy responds to this, because he decides that the only way to really know if Santa is real is to stay up. And he listens for Santa's sleigh bells, essentially being one of the things that can help you determine if Santa is real or not. And it's interesting because it's not seeing Santa, like going downstairs and seeing if Santa's there, but rather hearing it, that maybe the bells are indicative that Santa is real, even though someone could fake those bells. But for this child, hearing it is something that would prove existence rather than simply seeing it. But any sensation, I'm sure, like just seeing it or hugging Santa, I don't know, one of those things would be fairly interesting. There's a quote I would like to read to you from this. On Christmas Eve many years ago, I lay quietly in my bed. I did not rustle the sheets. I breathed slowly and silently. I was listening for a sound a friend had told me I'd never hear. Ringing bells of Santa's sleigh. And right there, like, you get what would determine the existence of Santa for this child, just hearing the bells. And he goes on to hear that he's not really hearing anything but the whistling of the various pipes in his house. And I think that's very interesting, because it's just a matter of hearing, of nothing else, not seeing Santa, just hearing. Even the smallest amount of proof for this boy is enough, because I think for him, he wants to believe, and because he wants to believe, like, any evidence will do rather than major evidence. And it's, this sleigh bell is interesting too, because that for him is proof of existence, and that carries on through the years. Anybody who doesn't believe in Santa doesn't hear the ringing of the bell. His sister eventually loses the ability to hear the bell, which means she doesn't believe in Santa anymore, but the boy continues through the ages. And that's something that I really like in this story, but it's also something I like in the movie, because the boy, like, spends the entire movie trying not to be duped. Like, that's the big problem, is, like, he wants to believe, but he also doesn't want to believe in something that's not true, because then he would be made a fool of, or something like that. And at the end of the story, like, while everyone's celebrating that Santa has arrived, he can't really see Santa, and he also can't hear the bell. And, like, there's a desperate scene where he's, like, ringing it, and it's, like, he hears nothing, and it's, like, I want to believe, like, let me believe. And It's very fascinating how, like, the movie and the book explores that belief. Not too much in depth in the book, but it is still a very interesting idea that we want to believe, and we're willing to accept even the minutest of evidence to keep that magic alive. Another interesting element of this story is that of magical realism. That's present in many Chris Van Allsburg stories. In Jumanji, you see it with the monkeys and the board game itself and the lion and all these, like, unusual events happening in the story. But here you see elves and the magic of the sleigh bell, Santa himself, and the train, the Polar Express itself, because, like, normally trains don't just form into existence while they're like right in front of your house. That's quite unusual. And this train apparently goes to the North Pole. It's pretty cool, but it's a great example of magical realism. There's also a dreamy element of this story, and that this could all very well just be a dream of, you know, of the North Pole, a dream of Santa that a kid who's near the end of his belief in Santa might be choosing, or not choosing to have, but, like, it just might be a dream that they had at this point in their life. Because there's, like, when he gets home, like, there's there's no bell, so there's no reminder that he was ever at the North Pole. So this could be a dream, this could be not. Although the fact that Santa gives him the bell at the end of the story, that's indicative that this is probably not a dream. And the last thing worth noting is the imagery of the story itself. There's a lot of great pictures, as there are with all Chris Van Allsburg stories, of just these unusual and bizarre things. The most notable standout thing to me is the title, and also one of the pictures in the story, which I'll put up here, is the picture of the train next to the houses. It's unusual and stand out, and all Chris Van Allsburg stories have unusual standout art, which in conjunction with the unusual stories that he often tells, it creates visual pictures that aren't easy to forget. I can very easily see the producers of the Polar Express using these pictures as a means of like creating the CGI in their stories, and that holds true, because the train and really the idea of the North Pole in the story are duplicated in the movie. So I think Allsburg does a great job and makes the CGI people's jobs a little bit less difficult by just giving them something to go off on. Anyway, those are my thoughts on The Polar Express by Chris Van Allsburg. It's a classic children's story, and it's a classic for a reason, because it tries to amplify the ideas of belief and the magic of Christmas, which I think it successfully does here. And, you know, it's very relatable for children, I would say, because, you know, especially at the young boy's age in this story, like, that was something that I was dealing with, like, is Santa real? Is Santa not real? I think it's pretty magical. Perhaps I'm just overanalyzing a book meant for children. I have a tendency to do that on this channel. If you read it before, or you simply want to comment on something I said here, please do so below in the comments. I would love to hear from you. Otherwise, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so that more people can find out about The Polar Express if they haven't done so already. And until then, I wish you the best of luck in your weird and North Pole travels. Farewell.